nerves on fight night? Now, you never looked very nervous when you was coming in the ring, but I know, you know, sometimes boxers can have the anticipation and the of the night. You know, did you ever suffer nerves, and how did you deal with it?
I must admit, I was always nervous out before I got to the stadium and all that, because I'm always thinking about things in my head and all that. But once I got into the changing room, I was never nervous. It just gone, because I accepted that I was going to be fighting, and it's nothing I could do now. I've said to this is what I'm here, this is what I'm about, so I'm most calm, and yeah, you know, it's crazy. I'm nervous outside, but once I'm in the change room, I'm perfectly okay. I think that's where I probably get the being a slow starter. Someone have to hit me or something, I get involved. Maybe that's where it's called, because I'm too relaxed and too calm. And then I think only one time I had a really, you know, that I want to rip someone's head off, it was when the Chris Eubank fight. And that's the only time I ever got angry, and I think it was in the first fight. And I think it was from the eighth round, I really wanted to take his head off. And then I just calmed down. I think I was never, you know, you got to have a fighter's got to have a bit of hatred in him. I mean, you know, you want to, I mean, I never had that, you know, that raw aggression, want to take your head off and all that business. And that's, you know, you gotta have that. It's like I don't know how to describe it. You're like your hair on your back is on edge, and you want, you know, you're up for it. You know what I mean? And I don't think I was up for my fight. I think I was probably sleeping or something. I don't know. I mean, because I was just too relaxed and too calm. You have to like a dog fight. You know what I mean? But you can't burn up too much energy. You got to know how to not go have a rage and burn up too much energy. And I'm trying to say something, but I'm not sure if I'm bringing it across, that you see someone, you want to take the head off, but you don't want to burn up too much energy, if that makes sense.
So you said you're asleep, but it was usually like that till about the eighth round, and then you come awake. And
no, I think that, no, but I wanted to have that, I'm going to, not say kill you mentally, truly, you know, you just want to have that, going to rip you apart, that raw aggression.
You've got to have.
Yeah, you've got to have that.
When you're going in there.
Yeah, you've got to have that. You're going to have that, and you want to hurt someone. And unfortunately, you don't want to literally hurt someone permanently for life, but you're getting punched yourself. So you're not
trying to do it to you if you don't do it to me.
I know, but I don't want to be hurting and putting someone in hospital in that sort of way I'm thinking, because that's not the way I'm thinking. But you as a boxer, you need to have that animal. It's me. I'm sorry. It's going to have to be you, but it's not going to be me. You look at the eighth round in the first fight, of course, and hopefully towards the end of it, you know what I'm getting at. Because that's the only time I really want to rip someone. You're so angry, you want to rip somebody's head off, and that's what I'm talking about. What you need, and I didn't bring that sort of. And probably sometimes I need to kick up the backside to tell you the truth. Yeah. And that's by getting hit when someone beat me up for three or four rounds. Then probably maybe that's when it kicks in, I don't know.
The feedback's been amazing. Everybody that's come in, we always do follow-ups. So everybody that's come in has loved it and come back for more. We're on Facebook, we're on Instagram. If you pass in, just pop in. We can give you a free consultation, give you a tour at the clinic and tell you everything that we do. Everyone's really friendly. Just come down and have a chat. So he's having the cryo facial, where we do a double cleanse, a tone, and then we use a spot cryo, which is a cold therapy. So it restricts the blood vessels in the face. Once they open up again and all the blood starts flowing, it produces more collagen. And so that helps with fine lines, wrinkles, any loose skin. As we get older, we lose collagen. So it's good to have a facial to keep the collagen reproducing. We do the cryolipo, which is a fat freezing. So if you go to the gym and you've got stubborn areas of fat that you can't get rid of, we can use the cryolipo on you, which helps get rid of those stubborn fat pockets. We also do cavitation and radio frequency, so that's body sculpting. Again, that's using radio frequency to get rid of small pockets of fat, and then skin tightening. So if you've got any loose skin around your tummy, thighs, we can tighten up your skin after that. We also have the cryo chamber that people come in for. So we have a lot of sports people that come in pre and post training. If they've got any injuries, they go in the chamber because you can heal 3 times quicker. Also, if somebody suffers from arthritis or aches or pains, going in the cryo chamber is amazing, gets rid of all that. Any inflammation or swelling, we can use the spot cryo, and that gets rid of bruising as well.